Hi everyone. Today I want to show you an alternative to the spool pins that come on the German singers. So we're talking the Singer 401G, 411G, 421G, 431G, those type of machines. Traditionally what we usually have if we replace them is we would put this pin together and with a bed cushion, and then we would put the washer back on and then put the push nut on here, and then hopefully it's tight enough. It might do a little flopping around or whatever. It's a little higher than it should, but what you'll find in a lot of cases is that these pins are no better and possibly not as good as the originals, and they still have all the same flaws as the original pins did. Additionally, they have a couple other problems. So the original pins were fragile, so were these ones. They were difficult to change. These ones are not actually a lot of fun either, because you need to remove this plate before you can even get at the pins. And every time you remove this plate, you risk a little bit of damage to both the plate and to the aluminum that is here that holds your push nut. And in fact, what you'll find is that mine doesn't even hold anymore because of how many times I've done demos and stuff and done videos for you guys showing you how to change these pins. So you get your fragile pins, your difficult to change pins. The other thing is that these pins are actually fairly short. So if you've got a modern spool of thread, like an Aurifil thread for instance, it's not really supporting the thread very well. So they weren't really the perfect solution to begin with. Now, the other thing that happens is that today, when replacing these pins, there's one supplier, and they're quite expensive. The suggested retail in Canada is almost $12 per pin. So you would be looking at two of these pins. More often than not, I find that the little spacers that go in here are missing. So then you also have to buy the bed cushions. These are featherweight bed cushions, in order to pad out this spool pin that should really never have had to be padded out. And then the other problem that you have is that because of this flange here, they're, at least in Canada, they are difficult to ship. They're expensive to ship. They are just big enough that if you want to ship this in letter mail, it has to go with no padding. And I don't know about you, but I certainly don't trust Canada Post with no padding in any kind of situation with fragile bits. So then what happens is now you're shipping for these pins, even if they're, you know, if they're, you know, two pins, is somewhere in the $13 to $15 range. So by the time you add up the price of the pins, the bed cushions, the shipping, you're looking at, you know, $50 Canadian dollars. If you want a shop to install them on top of that, you're probably going to be in excess of $75, because it's going to take them some time to get in, remove this plate without damaging it, and then put the pins on. Hopefully none of them come apart as they're putting everything back together, because they don't give you a heck of a lot of extra space here to be able to assemble anything. And these bed cushions are a little bit bigger than the originals. So it's not really the best solution. The other thing that happens is the next time you tilt the machine back against the wall to do some oiling, crunch, crunch, and you're in for another $50 worth of pins. So there had to be a better solution, and it turned out there was. Probably approaching a year ago now, I had a gentleman named John from the UK contact me and said, "Hey, I think I know a better way." So he showed me what he was doing, and I thought, you know what? This is elegant. It doesn't look bad at all. It matches the machine. Maybe it doesn't look original, but it certainly matches the rest of the chromed bits on the machine. And it's sturdy, and the pins are very easily replaceable. So this is what I want to show you today, is these. This replacement pin will solve every one of the problems that I talked about. And it's inexpensive, which is even better. So what these are here are chain ring bolts. And you can get these in double chain ring, triple chain ring, single chain ring. These, I believe John said, are double chain rings. And so what these do is they hold the gears on a bicycle right where your pedals are. So you may have one or two or three of those gears. These are the chain ring bolts that are holding them together. So the way that John has repurposed them is to stick the bigger end of the two into the hole. And now what you may find, if you've never done this before, is you may find that this is actually a little bit too big to fit in there. If that's the case, just take a little bit of sandpaper, coil it up into a tube, and just sand a bit in here until it gets to be the right size. Even if you take off all the paint, which is usually the only thing that really has to be taken off, all you're going to do is expose a little bit of aluminum. It's not going to rust. So go ahead and do that until your chain rings fit. Then, in order to install them, you're going to take this. And now what he sent me was these little pieces that he'd cut out of an inner tubing from a bicycle pump. Now you could also use washers that fit in here, that fit over top of here, or any kind of spacer you could think of. But what he's done is he slips this over top of here, and it's fairly tight. And that does two things. One, it makes it so that the chain ring is not going to fall out, but it also can adjust the height. So if he had cut this about a millimeter taller, then what would have happened is it would actually determine the height of the top of the holder for the spool pin. So then the next step is to just screw this in here the way that it's built. And now if you buy the chain rings, what I suggest is that you get the ones that have the Allen key heads. So you'll see that these ones have an Allen key slot and a blade slot to tighten them up. There are ones with Torx out there, and they're kind of a pain in the butt, but that's really the only requirement for these chain ring bolts, because we don't really need any high strength or anodized metal or anything like that. So we don't need to be paying for the really expensive chain ring bolts. We can just buy whatever's out there with a good head on it that's easily managed. So once you've got the two pieces assembled, just go ahead and assemble your third piece. In my case, because these are an Allen head, I can take my Allen wrench and go ahead and tighten this down. Now, if you have the right size screwdriver, you can... I'm not going to get that to work. You can tighten this down a little tighter. In my case, I'm not sitting here with the right screwdriver at the moment. Anyways, once that's tightened down, you can take the spool pin. And I'll put the number of the spool pin in the description below, because I didn't actually have it here when I started the video. And you have two choices here. So they're height adjustable in two ways. One, you can make your chain ring sit higher or lower depending on how many spacers you use down here. The other thing that you can do is you can choose a taller pin or a shorter pin. And so these shorter pins are great if they're going to be going into a portable case that doesn't have the height, or if they're going to be going into a cabinet. If neither of those is an issue, like the machine that I have up here, because it usually sits elsewhere, then I prefer to use the bigger pins. And the reason for that being is that's going to support a spool of Aurifil or a lot of the modern threads a lot better than this pin is. The other thing it is you'll notice that it's a little bit wider and in diameter, and that actually also stabilizes the spool pin and quiets it a little bit, because it's not going to spend as much time rattling back and forth. Both things that I quite like. I much prefer the quieter pins. So then once you've got this in here and ideally tightened down, in my case it's not tight, but you know that you need to tighten this down, then all you do is you can push your pin in here. That's almost down. Ideally you would try to avoid tapping it in, because some of these pins are fairly brittle these days, but you could probably get away with a very gentle couple of taps with a rubber mallet. Then once you've got your pin on, you can stick your spool pin felt on there, and it pr- pretty much looks original even from here. So that is how to change these spool pins out to chain ring bolts and spool pins. And the other thing that's a bonus here is there's the height adjustable if you wanted that, but they're also easy to change. Let's say you did lean your machine back and smash it into the wall and crack, crack, you busted both of them off. It's as simple as taking this pin out and replacing it. So these pins are typically probably about $1 at retail, so they're much, much more reasonable than the original pins. If you do find yourself in a situation where it's broken off low enough that you need to punch it out from the backside, you should be able to actually stick a pin or stick a punch of some sort in here and not even have to remove the entire plate. So that should also save some wear and tear on this plate, which is wonderful. The other thing that you can do is if you do happen to have your machine in a portable case or in a cabinet and you really, really want those tall pins, you can also just remove your pins and put them beside the machine before you put them into the case, fold them down into the cabinet, or in my case, stick them in a cubby hole. So I really think these are pretty much the best of all worlds in this case, and I think that they fix the one design flaw that I really think that this series of machines had, and a pointless design flaw, because they're not the same as the North American machines in this case. I think that's about it. If you have any further questions or comments about this video and what I've done here, leave me a message below, and have a good day.